the hidden treasure. In this chapter, I have already explained half portion of this story, and now today I will explain the remaining half of the story. So students, go through the video and watch it carefully. Lesson 4, the hidden treasure. In this story, I have explained you the half portion of this story, that it is a story of a farmer who had three sons who were lazy and they never helped their father in his farming work. And one day when the farmer became seriously ill, he called his son and he said that I am going to die soon, and I have hidden a treasure in one of my field, and that treasure is for you. The sons were very happy and they asked for him where he had hidden those treasure, and he said that he said to his first son that he can't remember where he has hidden that treasure. Maybe in the big field at the side of the house, or maybe it is in the back side of the house, or maybe it is in front of the house, the field which is in front of the house, there he had kept or he had hidden his treasure. Now we will start half portion of the story, that after his death, the sons began digging the three fields to find the treasure. Then they used a plow to dig further. They did not find any treasure. They decided to sow seeds in the fields as they had already plowed them. Soon there was a good crop which they harvested. They sold the crop and got a lot of money. Now after his death, the three sons, as their father has told him them that he had hidden the treasure in three sides of the field, he did not remember where he had hidden. So the three sons began to dig the three fields to find the treasure. They took the plow. Plow is a implement which is used for digging the land. So they used, with the help of plow, they start digging the land, but they did not find any treasure. And when they saw that they have plowed all the field, whole field, and didn't find any treasure, they decided to plant some seed or scattered seed in the field. And when they have sowed it, soon after time they saw a good crops were grown up from those seeds. Then they harvested it. They cut those crops and they sold those crops to the in the market and got a lot of money. Then they realized that they had found their father's treasure, and then they realized that it was the real treasure which they have earned by doing hard working in the field, and this was his father's treasure which his father had told him. The crops which they earn, the crops which they grow by their hard working in the field, and the money which they got by selling those crops, that was the real treasure. One son thought for a while and said, "Our father was a clever man. He knew how lazy we are and how much we dislike farm work. So he told us he had hidden a treasure in some field." Then one son realized, he thought and said that their father was a very clever man, and his father knew that they were lazy and they don't like farming work. So he had decided to told these his three sons that he had hidden a treasure in some fields, so that they must plow the land and they sow the seed and they can grow their crops and earn money. The second son said, "He knew we would dig for that, but not for plowing and sowing seed." And the second son said that his father knew that for treasure we will dig the land, but we will not plow or sow the seed. We will not dig the land for plowing or sowing seed. We will dig the land only to find out the treasure. His father knew. The third son said, "We know now that real treasure lies in the fruit of hard work." And in the end, the third son also said that, "Now we came to know that real treasure is in our hard work." After getting the fruit of hard work, that was the real treasure. So this is the story of a farmer and his three sons, and how in the end they came to know the real fruit of hard work. So students, go through the video, watch it carefully and read this story. Try to understand the real meaning of treasure. After this, in our next video, we will do this read and understand. Thank you.